This video is going to demonstrate how to collect a new piece of information using the form entry module and InfoPath. First thing we want to do is define the question that we want to collect data on. I'm going to give a shout out to Burke and use his typical example of nose hair density. It's not in my dictionary, so I'm going to have to add a new concept. And we're going to call that nose hair density. And it is a numeric concept, and we'll give it a maximum thickness of 5 millimeters. And it's added. The next thing we need to do is create a form to collect this information. And so the easiest thing to do is duplicate off the basic form. Call this the nose hair density form. Now we need to define all of the questions that can be collected before we're able to paint this form. So we see nose hair, we can drag it over into our obs section, give it a field number of 1, and set the field number to 2 for weight. Now we need to go to a Windows machine and paint this form using InfoPath. You can download the XSN and you want to save it. I just saved it to my desktop. I will design this with InfoPath. First thing you want to do is just drag the value over onto your form and label it however you want. Let's also collect weight. Drag weight over. And InfoPath uses the typical drag and drop painting techniques that most office products have. And we just do a save. I'll save this to the desktop as new starter. And now I need to upload this painted form to the server. So I'll browse to my new starter, open it, and upload it to the server. And now the server knows about the form, and I can fill out a form for one of my patients. So John has no encounters right now. So let's fill out the nose hair density form. And we want to open this with InfoPath directly to do the actual filling of the form. You can see the nose hair density here. And one of the nice things that InfoPath gives us is error checking. So because we had put a maximum of 5 on the concept, it won't let me put in a value higher than 5 millimeters. Fill in all of the required fields here and submit this to the server. Submitted forms don't show up immediately. It's put into a queue and processed every 30 seconds. So we can go make sure our queue is running. And our form entry queue is running. After it's processed in that queue, it is sent to the HL7 queue. And after that, it's turned into an actual row in the encounter table. And we have data for John. So let's go back and find him, see if it's finished processing. We see a new encounter for John. We can view that encounter. We see there's a nose hair density of 2 and a weight of 123. We can go and edit the encounter. And that's it. We now have a new piece of information that is being collected inside of OpenMRS.